and it's going to be one of those things that you said I was there when it happened.
Well, you made the point before talking with Bruce prior to that first final. It could be the end of an era. Will pop off if he loses this. I mean, yeah. What does that tell him, do you think? Will he go on?
Oh, I would have thought so.
Sydney?
Yeah, I mean, he's... Alex's preparation, this is just a part of the preparation for 2000. He talks in terms of Olympics, and in between Olympics is the World Championship. So his preparation, this is part of a prep for Sydney 2000, because his words were, if you win 100 freestyle gold medal, you're good. If you win back-to-back, which he's done, you're great. But if you win three back-to-back, like Dorney did, then you are a superstar. So that's how high he set the bar, and that's what he's working towards.
Chris Feidler qualified in lane one, 25 years of age now. National champ for 5 years before Klim beat him last year. Great to see him in this final.
I think it's a big credit to Chris making this final. It's the 100 free and the 50 free would have to be the hardest finals to make.
And if they gave out gold medals for being good, a good bloke, he'd have a bag full.
Definitely.
One of the nicest fellas you've ever met.
Scott Tucker from the USA, who finished fifth behind Klim of the Pan Pans.
Isn't it unusual to see two, not only not have two Americans in the final, but one in lane two? Normally you're looking at lanes four, five or three, and there's a couple of them there. Definite change of the guard. This kid is hot. 49-1 as a teenager is just, I can't comprehend it.
He'd have to be getting tired, wouldn't he? This is his third race in 3 days.
He's gone race for race with Michael Klim. Mm-hmm. Heats and finals of both, the 200 free and the relays.
So he's already got two gold medals. Michael Klim. Memorable was Monday night in the 200. Can he grab this?
Let me make this point again. Up until a few weeks ago, this was a bit of a throwaway event for Michael Klim. He came here for the 200 free, he's won that, and he's the world record holder in the 100 butterfly.
And there's Alex Popov. Does he look confident?
He is awesome.
And what about tactically in this race? Does Klim need to be in front of the 50?
I think it'll be a race where he just needs to worry about himself. The thing is, Alex has got that much speed. If he wants to use it, then it might not be a good thing to be in front of him at the 50, if that makes any sense.
Now here's a guy who knows all about chasing Alexander Popov, the bronze medalist in Atlanta, the silver medalist in Barcelona, Gustavo Borges. Very rhythmical in the water.
He's got one of the best techniques I've ever seen.
Frölander, the silver medalist at the European Championships, behind Popov.
And just to give it a bit more enormity for Michael Klim, what he's about to undertake, I believe Alexander Popov is the greatest sprinter ever. Throw Biondi in, throw Mark Spitz in, Mike Wynn, and whoever you like. Before this race tonight, as we sit here right now, Popov is the greatest.
Zubor, he swam a 52.9 this morning. So,
this is it.
We're set to go.
Showtime.
Popov in five, Klim is in four. And already this crowd is finding voice. This should be a big one. We remember the duel Popov and Gary Hall.
And a contrast in techniques as well.
Yep. There's a new challenger on the block now, and Popov has got to put that challenge down. Michael Klim, the star so far of this meet. Popov and Klim, side by side. There's a hush. And away, and Klim got a very good start in lane four. Popov immediately up and stroking, though, at his shoulder. And Popov has taken the early lead. Klim trying to go with him. Borges not far away. Van Hoogenband is coming through as well in lane three.
It looks like Michael's doing it a little tough to stay with Alex at the moment. It's a different swimmer in Popov in the final tonight. They were out in 23.8 this morning. Watch out for them to be quicker tonight. As it is, they go round 23.5. It is on.
Well, Popov is looking smooth in second place. Van Hoogenband. And coming on now is Klim. Popov is hard to beat in this situation. He's out by a meter. Klim is working hard, trying to go with him. Popov looking terrific. Popov, rhythmical. He's out by half a body length. I think the Australian dream is going to fall short. Popov is going to win. Klim is hanging on. Feidler not far away, but Popov wins. Very tight for second. Klim got second. and third would have been Frohlander across in lane seven.
48.93. Alexander Popov has gone under that magical 49 barrier yet again. Klim second in 49.20. And once again, he's made his family proud, Michael Klim. But the man is still Alexander Popov.
Great to see Chris Feidler, the other Australian, breaking 50 seconds as well.
That is a superb swim by Chris Feidler.
Well, it was quite decisive in its way. We talked about the challenge. Well, he snuffed it out.
And they both got off the blocks brilliantly.
For Popov, that's a great start, isn't it?
Yes.
Sometimes he dwells just a little bit.
When it counts, as we've said before, the champions do that. They almost go round together. They both came off the wall well. Alex won the race in his third 25 here. And as we saw Michael Klim do in the heats this morning, he didn't breathe the last 15 metres and started to come back at Alex again.
That was a real gutsy swim because Klim, I think, sensed that Popov had got away. But
look at the technique underwater. See, it's just about identical. It doesn't matter what you're doing on top of the water. And I tell you what, it was a lot closer than a lot of people will realise when you see how hard Klim was charging. But he is the greatest ever.
I always think back to that final in Atlanta when Gary Hall seemed to have him everywhere, but on the wall. He finds a way of winning, doesn't he?
What I want to know is, what did Gennady Turetsky, who trains both of them, tell them both to do before their race?
I think maybe go out and enjoy it.
Well, here they are, the gold and silver medalists, talking with Lindley Fray.
Congratulations, Alex. Back-to-back world championships and a championship record. You've got to be happy.
Oh, I don't know yet. Haven't realised it yet. Still swimming.
Michael, were you aware of each other during the race and before the race?
No, not at all. I mean, I was really concentrating on myself during that, and I could only see the, you know, a faint white sort of splash on the right-hand side, but I breathed the other side, so I didn't really see him.
Congratulations, both of you. It's wonderful.
Well, they've gone 1-2 as we expected. Alexander Popov, the defending champion, the Olympic champion, prevails at Challenge Stadium. Bruce?
Thanks very much, Dennis. It was a great race, and Klim came back strongly. Popov used his edge, his great speed early, to set it up, get to the lead, and Klim coming back, and Feidler also under 50 seconds. The final results haven't come through. We're waiting to see exactly what time everybody finished up with, but Popov inside 49, and I think Klim was at 49.20, and Feidler also under 50 seconds. We'll have those shortly. So a final that I think lived up